Bonjour à tous. Je voudrais aujourd'hui partager avec vous les éléments clés à prendre en considération.
I would like to share key elements with you to need to be taken into consideration when trying to organize sustainable supply of palm oil and its derivatives. How can you have certification, traceability, all along the supply chain, which, as you know, is extremely controversial. Palm oil. First of all, palm oil is the top vegetable oil produced in the world, 62 million tons in 2016. This production of palm oil is essentially geared at the agri-food business that uses 75% of it. Palm oil and its derivatives are also used in industrial products, in household products, and in consumer goods such as cosmetics. Over the past few years, there's also been a marked increase in palm oil demand for use in biofuels. Palm oil is essentially produced in Southeast Asia, although production is growing in West Africa and Latin America. Why palm oil? Quite simply, because the palm oil tree is one of the most productive plants with a yield per hectare that can be up to 10% higher than other oleaginous plants. Just two figures, 5.5% of the palm oil surface produces 32% of the world's oil production. I was saying that production was essentially centered in Southeast Asia, and that is essentially Indonesia and Malaysia, which with 50 million tons account for about 85% of global production, which means that very small parts of land, Sumatra, Borneo, the Malay Peninsula, have a very strong pressure. The increase in production over the past 10 years led to a multiplication by three of the surface where it is grown, with many environmental and social impacts. First of all, deforestation, which leads to a loss of species and a destruction of habitats. Then, peat bogs become dry. A slash and burn emits dangerous particles and large amounts of greenhouse gases. Large plantations have grown based on a concession system, and in these large plantations, working conditions need to be controlled and to make sure that they remain humane. These major plantations are not the only producers of palm oil, because 40% of production is still controlled by independent producers. In Indonesia, these independent producers grow about 2 hectares on average, and the policy has allowed Indonesia to bring a major part of its population out of poverty in just one generation. But these small growers do not have a perfect mastery of agricultural techniques. Their yield is far lower than that of a greater plantation, sometimes 50% lower yields. So in order to increase their revenues, they may be tempted to expand through deforestation and, by doing so, destroy protected areas. The production of palm oil is centered in mills, which receive every day the fruits of the palm trees. The fruits need to be transformed in under 48 hours, between 24 and 48 hours, meaning that the location of the mills is crucial, both because it is the hub around which plantations are organized and because it is the basic unit for the definition of territorial policies. The fruit are transformed into oil in these mills, into palm oil from the flesh of the fruit, and in palmist oil, using the fruit's kernel. In cosmetics, we use very little palm or palmist oil. What we do use is essentially derivatives of palm and palmist oil. These derivatives are essential because each one has a particular function which is necessary for our product's efficacy. If you take the example of glycerol, it's a moisturizer, fatty esters are emollients, fatty acids can be used as emulsifiers or as surface agents, fatty alcohols as emulsifiers, sulfates as detergents, or ammonium salts as conditioners for hair care products. When you look at all of these derivatives and what they account for compared to the global production, the footprint of L'Oréal is very low compared to world production, because with only 700 tons of palm oil per year and 60,000 tons of palm oil derivatives, we only account for 0.1% of global production and use. However, we are very keen to make sure our supply is sustainable, and we take our responsibility very seriously in this respect. First of all, we rely on certification, which comply with a certain number of rules. They promote rules of implementation and they verify the results. It's the case for the RSPO certification, Roundtable and Sustainable Palm Oil, which, on the initiative of the WWF, brings together all stakeholders, producers and local stakeholders, to develop principles of sustainable plantation and production. L'Oréal joined the RSPO in 2007. All of our palm oil is now has been in compliance with principles of RSPO since 2012, and now so are the derivatives. However, only a low percentage is RSPO certified in the production as a whole, so we need to help the system to be rolled out more widely so that it can have better effects. And we can do this by working on the ultimate traceability of the products, because the supply chains are extremely complex, especially for derivatives. And that's why in 2014 we initiated a major traceability program with the assistance of our suppliers and an independent third party, in order to be able to trace all of the derivatives we use all the way back at least to the mill, which, as we saw, is the hub and focal point for potential territorial developments. So we have worked with our direct suppliers to go all the way back to the refineries and mills, and we now have 75% of our palm oil derivatives that can be traced all the way back to the mill. How does this help? It helps us to identify the territories from which our palm oil derivatives come, palm oil and palmist oil, for the use of our derivatives, and to launch locally a number of projects, such as this Spotspan project, that was Spotspalm project launched in a partnership with our supplier, Clariant Global Amines and Wilmar, and the NGO Wild Asia, to provide support for 500 farmers to help them organize. And that is what the NGO does locally in the field, working with the farmers to help them adopt best farming practices, help them access certification, the RSPO certification. Accessing RSPO certification is very important in order for them to sell their production. So all of the supply chain, and L'Oréal particularly, has committed to purchase their production. And therefore, our objective is to reach 70,000 tons of certified substances. So the Spotspalm project is a pilot project, which is meant to allow us to develop broader territorial approaches, and we're working on this with our suppliers in order to continue to work on sustainable supply, increasingly sustainable supply of palm oil.